Hey everybody, I don't know how much you can tell, but my forehead, nose, and cheeks are pretty red today because I spent all day out in the sun yesterday and I did not use sunscreen or sun protection besides sunglasses. You should know that that never happens. I grew up not being told to wear sunscreen by my parents, and then I lived in Australia for 3 months and did not wear sunscreen. I lived in Mexico for 3 months working outside on the ocean and didn't wear sunscreen. And then in my grad school days, I worked in the Florida Keys, and there was this one person and they were wearing a bikini and they were older, and the words that came to mind were canyon cleavage. It was just so, like, the depth of the wrinkles were previously unknown to me. So it isn't like the skin cancer or anything that really threw me off of not wearing sun protection. It's how old I would look and how young I would be at the time. So anyway, I wear sunscreen all the time. So you should know, I do not get red like this anymore. Don't. But yesterday I was using the UV index to figure out how much sun protection I needed. And so it obviously didn't work right, and I wanted to figure out why, and now I want you to know how to use this tool too. Light is emitted from the sun across a wide range of wavelengths. Infrared light we can feel as heat. Visible light we can see, that's why it's called visible light. Good job, everyone. Ultraviolet light we can't see or feel, which is unfortunate because it can cause skin damage. Short exposure periods to ultraviolet light can be good for you because you need a little bit of ultraviolet light to get enough vitamin D for your body. Vitamins are a whole separate conversation, but everyone agrees that you need some ultraviolet light in order to keep your body working right. The tricky thing is that different skin types, different places on Earth, different conditions in those same places, all of those things can change the amount of UV radiation that you get on your skin and can change how harmful or good that is for your skin. It's funny because most of the time when I'm trying to take care of my body, it's like I'm making a conscious decision and I'm accepting it all as worth it. Like if someone says you probably shouldn't drink liquid butter, I'm like, okay, but tonight I want to drink liquid butter because it's delicious. But in this case, UV radiation, it's not like I want to have a sunburn, and it's not like I even realize it till it's too late, so I just really don't appreciate not being able to be in control of this. UV index tells you how much UV light you can expect to get to a certain location on the surface of the Earth. The scale works just like you'd expect it to. Lower numbers mean lower amounts of UV radiation on your body, reaching your location on Earth. Higher amounts mean higher amount of radiation. But how you interpret this scale is the really tricky part, and that's where I got tripped up, and that's what sunburned me and my family. I found a lot of websites that said 1 to 3, you're good to go, you don't need any sun protection. And then I saw other websites that said 1 to 3, you should cover up and wear sunscreen and sunglasses. And it's like, well, which one is it? I am here to tell you with my very red face that it is the second one. After a bit more digging, I found some websites that talked about the UV index in terms of time you could remain outside before you burn. And I know this is not going to be consistent for everyone, again, different skin types and everything, but I think this was the most useful way for me to think about it. So several websites I saw said UV index 1 to 3, you might burn if you have fair skin after about 60 minutes. Think about it as I really need to be paying attention so that I am maximum outside for an hour before I do something else to protect my skin. And then the mid-ranges, you could be outside for, you know, 30 minutes or so. And then 11 plus, someone who doesn't burn easily can only be outside for about 10 minutes before they start to take on a bit of sun damage from the UV radiation. I do not burn easily. For a white person, I have pretty dark skin and it tans very easily rather than burning. And I was in UV1 for several hours around solar noon, and I am red today and it is sore today. Not gonna peel. Bing! This is video editing Virginia coming in to say that it totally peeled. But don't do what I did. I'm putting some links with this video so that you can decide for yourself how you're going to use the UV index to protect yourself. And as always, I am not a medical doctor. I have a PhD, I am proud to say, but I am not a medical doctor. This is not medical advice. Make sure you do what works for you and pay attention to your own skin. But also don't fall into the trap that I fell into. Now you know. I hope you make some good decisions with this. Bye! I don't know if y'all can hear it, but my husband is up in our bedroom where our office currently is. And my husband. He's tapping a rhythm with his feet, and I guarantee he doesn't know he's doing it.